This is Huawei's new MateBook 16. It's a Ryzen 7 5800H powered 16-inch laptop with a 3:2 aspect ratio IPS screen. Backlit keyboard, very large glass touchpad. It can run two external monitors from its two full-spec Type-C ports. And it does have this version I was sent out from Huawei, up to 16 gigabytes of RAM, and this one has 512 gigabytes of storage. Now, I just wanted to point out that this is a loan unit. After my review, I have to send it back to Huawei. I'm not being paid for this video, and all opinions expressed, like all my reviews, are 100% my own. Weight-wise, I think this is a decent weight for a 16-inch full-metal laptop, just a fraction over 2 kilos. And with our supercharger, the total travel weight then does come up to almost 2.4 kilos. This laptop's thickness is around approximately 19 millimeters. That's not including the rubber feet on the bottom. So we do have here alloy. It's a complete metal build, high quality, very, very good. It's a premium laptop. Now pressing down on the lid, there is almost no flex. So you don't have to worry about the screen pressing up against the keyboard because, well, it's covered with glass. And I'll get onto that shortly, that screen. So yes, you can open it up one-handed. So this is our backlit keyboard. Now we do have a first level, which is a lot duller, and then the second. Now it looks a little bit brighter here than how I'm capturing it with my camera and my lens and all my setup. But I wanted to show you too, we've got this, which is the pop-up camera, of course. So this we have seen before on the MateBook Pro Series the X, and that is our front-facing HD webcam, which are people either don't like it or some people actually do because it's hidden away and more private. So there is a way to hold our function key, so when this is on, you don't need to do the function and then press those. You can either disable that for the media controls, brightness, volume. We've got half-size arrow keys, and we do even have a mute key right here too with a status LED. The same status LED is in the caps lock too as well. But overall, this is a great keyboard to type on. So speakers either side, I will give you a sample of those two in this review, of course, and a glass touchpad. Now this one does support Windows 10 gestures like they all do nowadays, left and right mouse buttons within it. And our power button here does have a fingerprint reader in it. It's a good X1, works really well. So you don't need to type out passwords to get into Windows. On the left here of the MateBook 16, we've got two full-spec Type-C ports, so they both accept power. You can use either one of them to power and charge the laptop. Status LED, so these do, both of them support 4K 60. Our HDMI port here is HDMI 2.0, so this is 4K 60 in theory, but I'm able to get 8-bit 4K 120Hz out to my LG CX TV. Not a problem, and it has been stable, no glitches or anything. A combo 3.5mm headphone and microphone jack there. And on the right, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports. And up the front, we have these two dual array microphones. These ones sound really good. Then the underside, we've got this intake grille right here. So all the fresh air is going to be sucked in. I can see two fans inside here, and they will have some thermal transfer heat pipes in there. Now, I can't, unfortunately, remove this rear cover and show you the internals. Strictly no teardowns allowed with this lone unit, unfortunately. So a large rubber foot here at the front. The one at the rear is slightly taller just to improve, of course, the ventilation. Now, we've got a great screen on this particular laptop because of this very, very slim bezel around the outside. We do have a 90% screen to body ratio. So it's all screen. 3:2 aspect ratio. It's covered with glass. It's scratch resistant and fully laminated. So optically bonded. You don't see any gap between the IPS panel than that glass. 2520 by 1680 is the resolution. Now, according to Huawei, maximum brightness should be 300 nits, but I do measure with my Spyder 5 Pro 286 nits. For indoor use is great. It is quite reflective, obviously, with the glass on it. I do wish it was a little brighter, though. If it was 350 nits, I think that would be ideal. Now, it does dull right down to only about 7 nits, which is great. So that's not bright at all. Good for late time use, and of course when you do that, that is really going to extend the battery life, which I'll get onto later on in this in-depth review. So taking a look now at our color gamut here, the coverage. So uncalibrated, it does have a bit of a bluish tint to it. That's now the uncalibrated view. Blue tint, definitely present. This is more of a neutral white now, calibrated, of course, with that Spider 5 Pro I've got. The color coverage here, the gamut. So we've got 94% sRGB, NTSC is 66%, Adobe RGB of 71%, P3 also 71%. And Huawei does include this, which is great. They've got an sRGB mode, eye comfort mode there, and you can tweak the color temperature. So as I mentioned, it's quite a bluish tint, whites out of the box here, but you're able to adjust it with this if you weren't going to be using, of course, a professional tool to calibrate this particular display. So the internal storage here, we do have a Samsung drive. This is PCIe 3.0 spec. Of course, AMD does not support PCIe 4, only the latest 11th gen Intels do. Very, very good speeds for PCIe 3, no problems there. Now this is a 512 gigabyte drive, and we do have the 16 gigabytes of RAM. Now I won't show you general performance on this laptop, just to let you know that it is very, very good. So documents, spreadsheets, all that sort of stuff is really quick on this, very, very fast. Now on first boot, you are looking at around here, you can see 70 gigabytes that is used for Windows, but they have partitioned this one into two separate partitions, which is the second one there for drive D, 337 gigabytes. Now you can of course change that with Partition Manager software if you're not happy about that at all. So the Cinebench R13 score, very, very good. This, of course, ran for 10 minutes for the single core score of just over 1,400 points and close to 12,000 points for multi-core score out of this Ryzen 7 5800H. Now, I did run the performance mode. You simply have to use function and then P to enable or disable this. So all the benchmarks I ran with the performance mode on, that is 54 watts. It's got 8 cores and 16 threads with this particular chipset, very, very potent. And of course it's got Vega graphics with this, so very, very quick. Now some other synthetic benchmarks here that I did go through. Geekbench 5 score here, so over 14,000 points single core score and just over 7,200 for multi-core score there. Seems a little bit low, I think, for the Ryzen 7 5800H. It should be a little bit better than this. I have seen a little bit better, especially when at 54 watts. Here is our PC Mark 10 score, getting just over 6,000 points, which is excellent. That just goes to show you that, what I was mentioning before, that it's very, very quick at your daily PC workloads and things like that, spreadsheets, all of that, really quick. Firestrike score here for integrated graphics with the Vega 8 graphics here, just over 3,000 points, 3,320. That is actually okay, that's good. For integrated graphics, of course, it's no dedicated gaming laptop, this one here. It's more for business use, what they're aiming at here. Night Raid score, so over 13,000 points, close to 14,000 again, is a good score. Time Spy, just over 1,300. And you can clearly see that this is, yes, not a gaming laptop as mentioned. So those are the synthetic benchmarks I have run on that. And there's a few other things I wanted to show. So we've got Huawei's PC Manager right here. And if you bring this up, it gives you a little bit more information about our PC spec right there. The display, that's a BOE092F, if you're interested in that. And there is our card right there for our internet, which is the very fast AX200, so that's Wi-Fi 6 spec. And my throughput through that one is just over 1.2 gigabits per second, so very quick, faster than a gigabit LAN port with that. And then thermals on this, for 60 hours of me just doing general kind of work, some light browsing of the internet, YouTube, then those benchmarks, stress testing it and gaming on it, it did not go over 92.8 degrees as our maximum there for the thermals. No thermal throttling on this, but it was only just a couple of degrees away from doing that. That was again in that performance mode. The fan noise, not too bad. It does have dual fans within there, but unfortunately, Huawei does restrict me with this lone unit that I'm not able to open it up, as I mentioned before, and show you those internals. Now we do have Huawei Share with this laptop. So if you have any Huawei devices, for example, their MatePad Pro, which I've got right here, using this, you are able then to connect up to them, share the screen, move over files quite easily, and you can view and just drag and drop things using Huawei Share from one device to another. Now you can also do what is called their multi-screen collaboration. Now, I've connected up right now in the mirror mode, so that's mirroring everything from the laptop screen of the MateBook 16 over to the MatePad 12.6. In the extended mode here, you can see the connection is very, very quick. It does work really well. And what has surprised me is the latency. So I'll just move this over now to this screen here. So I set that up as a second extended screen here, so I can take a look at content on that, move them over. So this is very handy if you've got a MatePad, for example, you can do a bit of work on that. When I go to the screen here, though, you'll see that when I scroll on it, it's not too bad. It's not perfect like a cable connection, which, by the way, you can also do. But wirelessly, I think for this kind of work, the latency, not too bad. Of course, you would not be using it for gaming or anything like that, but for working with spreadsheets, this is very handy. Now, this by far is the biggest letdown of this particular MateBook 16, like we're seeing with their previous laptops, is we have, of course, that horrible location for a webcam, and it's just above our number keys right there. So this points, well, up your nose, up your neck. It's not a flattering position. Not only that, the webcam quality does look very grainy. Now, excellent quality from the Dual Array front-facing microphones, which are just in front of the touchpad. And if you were typing away on the keyboard in, say, a Zoom meeting, people would see your fingers. You can hear a little bit of feedback there, but that is kind of typical. However, I really think it's overdue now that Huawei needs to move this webcam into the top bezel. I'm sure they can do it. Now, this laptop has the upward firing speakers here and here. They do sound really good. I like them. Good volume, a little bit of bass to them too. Here is a sample at 100% volume. And moving over to gaming, so older titles like this one, GTA 5 running on, which is basically just over 720p resolution on normal settings, you get close to 60 frames per second. And you'll note up here that it does hold a 2000 megahertz maximum turbo on the Vega 8 graphics, which is good. That means it's not throttling down. Thermals are great when you're gaming, and the fan noise is just a light whooshing noise. It's really not that offensive. So these older titles, you're able to play a little bit on the side with a decent frame rate as long as you lower down the visuals and the resolution. You're not going to be running the max resolution because it simply won't be able to hand it with that Vega 8 graphics. Still, this is very good performance for integrated graphics. And I'll have a look now at Counter-Strike and we'll see how that one performs. So I do have this one running on what is basically medium settings and 1080p, but it's 1680 by 1080 or something to keep with that 3:2 aspect ratio. So it looks really good. And we've got a frame rate here over 120 frames per second. I've seen it get up to about 160 maximum. It does sometimes dip below 100, but it really is quite good. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay. Dead straight away there. But you get the idea. That nice frame rate here, very, very playable with older titles. Video editing, this is with Adobe Premiere Pro. So I have installed the latest version. Now the timeline, if I keep the playback resolution here on full, which is the full 4K 100 megabit per second files, I can see that it sometimes is dropping a few frames per second with that. So it's better to really run it at a half resolution or quarter resolution for the playback. Now, I just do basic edits, so no fancy transitions or anything like that. The timeline seems to be quite good, relatively lag-free, good performance from that Ryzen 7, the 5800H. Export time now, so what I'll do is my typical test, it's 1 minute of footage at the YouTube 4K preset, and that is H.264. We'll see how long it takes to export just 1 minute. So we're down now to the last 5%. I'll hit pause here once that bar completely disappears. There we go. So about 1 minute, and you can roughly say 3 to 4 seconds to encode 1 minute of 4K 100 megabit footage to the YouTube preset. Now the battery life on this one is not bad at all. I think it's very good. So with light use, 30% brightness, in the balance mode, so I did not use the power mode up to 54 watts. Streaming YouTube videos, light work, documents, internet, stuff like that, with just the 30% brightness, I was able to get close to 9 hours. So that is excellent. All up, I mean, this is a really good laptop. I have thoroughly enjoyed my time using and testing this lone unit here from Huawei. Backlit keyboard is great to type on. We've got that very large glass touchpad and just an overall general excellent build quality. I think the weight too is not bad at all for a 16-inch laptop. Of course, 3:2 aspect ratio. The brightness I wish was a little brighter than the approximate 280 nits I'm able to achieve out of this. So they do claim 300, but still, indoor use, it's perfectly fine, fully laminated, and that high resolution means you get a lot of workspace on this, which I do find is great and good for documents, reading, things like that. So it's a work-orientated machine. Good speakers, very good charge time too. It's just over an hour and 30 minutes with their supercharging. What about the things I don't like about it? Apart from my minor complaint about the screen brightness, I wish it was a little brighter, is this right here. They're still using that pop-up webcam, and I don't like that looking up your nose, your neck location of it. Now, I do believe with Huawei's engineering, they should be able to put it up here in the top bezel. I do get it, and I know that a lot of people in the comments will probably mention, but Chris, you're missing the point here, that it's hidden away, the webcam, and that means for privacy reasons, having it closed like that, yes, that is good, okay? I do understand that, but still, I would like them to see them to actually incorporate it into that top bezel. So there we go. Overall, I think this is a fantastic laptop here. Pricing, it's not super cheap, but I don't think it's too bad considering the spec on offer. So it's about 1,200 euros here in Europe for premium build quality, the great keyboard with the 16 gigabytes of RAM and the 512 gigabytes of storage. That's great. And unfortunately, I couldn't show you the insides of it. Okay, no tear down, couldn't show you the expandability. So I don't know if we can add another SSD or anything like that. Sorry, I just couldn't take a look. Unfortunately, that's just the way it is with these lone units. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I do hope to see you back in the next laptop review from me.